Good morning, everyone. I want to thank all of you for being here. It's a great program for the world day before. We begin the masses, and then we will begin the mass. Crossing the line, and offer a few words of our work to you.
Before I stop the meeting, I would like to give special thanks to our celebrants, Anthony Vero, Father Clement, and Father Simon. Thank you for honoring my mom by making this baptism special. Also, thank you to your wife for organizing the music and bringing our soloist, Deb Fleming, and violinist Emily Chang and Joanne Squire to join in the celebration of my mom's life. As I look at all of you gathered here today, under the common bond of paying tribute to my motherland, I can't help but imagine how pleased she would be of all your concern, your respect, your adoration, and your love. My mom was born on November 23rd, 1922, the daughter of her loving mother, Eva, and dad, Oscar Bohan. She was raised here in West Warwick, attending St. John's School, and graduating from West Warwick High School. She worked in the rectory here at St. John's for many years, and she sang in the choir. Afterwards, she attended a nursing division in Cambridge, Massachusetts, that was operated by the Sisters of Charity. She worked for a short period of time at St. Joseph's Hospital in Providence. She married my dad in 1948, and in 1951, I was born. My mom loved this town, and she loved living in a home in West Warwick, where she was raised. She was proud to own this home. It was a central location. It was the homestead. It was where families would visit on Saturdays and Sundays, and where all the family holidays were celebrated. We are here to give homage to a very kind, caring, and giving woman. She leaves us with warm memories of her good heart and generous nature. Her greatness lies in her love for her family. My mom's role, together with that of my dad, was to give their daughter the very best. They prioritized the importance of education that was second to none, and they worked hard to also give me easy piano and violin lessons. They drove me all over the state to always give me the very best. My mom's love knew no bounds. My successes were hers, and I knew that I was her life and her joy. She cherished her family and her friends. She welcomed you into her house, providing you with food equivalent to the banquet for her family. Recognize that through my mom, you have identified life's greatest attributes, those of love and of self-giving. She instilled in me strong values about life, love of family, the importance of faith, and a strong devotion to St. Angelo's prayer. For over 25 years, my parents and I made a yearly pilgrimage to St. Anne's Shrine in Quebec. Arranging for me in celebration of my parents' 50th wedding anniversary, with a high mass in silver. My mom and I made that pilgrimage together to attend that third session mass in July 1998. My mom also had a great love of animals. Her dog Princess was appropriately named, and she made it her daily responsibility to also feed and to the same bird, dog, or cat. How I believe that St. Francis would look down on her and smile, as well as bless her. My mom's wealth was in her goodness. She gave to each of us through an abundance of great natural gifts. One of those gifts was her modeling of a strong mindset and an honest character. She had no problem to tell anyone exactly where they stood in her book. She possessed no veneer. Though faced with the prognosis of her death 3 months ago, my mom maintained throughout each remaining day a positive focus that she could work towards getting better. St. Benedict writes that our life in this world is like a ladder, which Jacob soared in his dream. In order to reach heaven, it must be planted by the Lord in a humble heart. My mom Lynch mounted this ladder step by step throughout her life, through her humility, her love, and her kindness. Remember that God made this life merely as a bridge to heaven, a passage, and from all indications of her life, my mom must have been warmly welcomed into God's kingdom. There is a saying that where there is great love, there are always miracles. Our family witnessed firsthand that miracle of her recovery from brain surgery in May 2001. In measuring our lives with pearls, it is clear how truly amazing my mom was. Lynn was a wife, a mother, a sister, an aunt, and a friend that we all loved very much. Mom, you're going to come down in a few minutes. If I had looked the whole world over, I could never have found a mother more perfect than you. If I could have chosen anyone at all for my mother, I would have chosen you. I am so fortunate that God put me in your family and gave me you as my mom. I can never thank you enough for all that you have done for me, taught me, and given to me. I can never repay you. All I can do is tell you and the world that I love you with all my heart, that I am grateful to you, and that I cherish you. I feel incredibly lucky to have a mom like you. The light that shines in you has always been here to illuminate the path in front of me. And there isn't a day that goes by without my life being formed by yours. In all the days of my life, from the most distant yesterday to the farthest tomorrow, I know that I will never stop thanking you for everything you have done to me, for me, And I believe that you will now be my angel and will always be there with me. So, Mom, thank you for your wisdom, your encouragement, your steadfast support, and your constant love. With all my heart, thank you for being a more precious gift than words can express. Thank you for being the best mother in the world. Remember that I love you, I always have, and I always will. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, and faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that there I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Part of the body of Christ, the church. And the Lord assured her
would always be by your side for this life, and that one day you would take care of yourself forever. When we think about a way of life that we heard so beautifully about in our son's words, we know that her life, like many others, had its ups and downs, joys and sorrows, its challenges. And yet, when we were always aware of her God, the Lord was by our side. She was a hard-working person, a kind person, a generous person, and although our son spoke from her experience as a daughter, I can say it as a friend of me, that you grew up in the neighborhood with very friendly people, sat out of work, talked, it was even very convenient, but also a neighborhood where people genuinely cared about each other and took care of each other in various ways. And Marceline's mother, Lynch, was very much a part of that neighborhood. She was also a woman of faith. Marceline alluded to that, and we know that over the course of her life, she was aware that the Lord was by her side. She knew Jesus through prayer, through receiving His presence in the Eucharist frequently. And I would even say that she knew Jesus through His mother and through His saints. The saints were very much her friends. When she went every year to different shrines, I remember as a child going with her to La Salette myself. They go to these shrines not just to visit a beautiful church, but to visit a friend. Every month, Marceline would take her to St. Bartholomew residence in Cynthia, where she wanted to see the statue of St. Bartholomew, who was the foundress of the Daughters of Charity. She had a great devotion to her, and the idea that she was one of his friends was impressed on me when Marceline said, every time she met her, she'd smile and wave and say, there she is. These saints and the Lord Himself were very familiar with her. And so today, as we gather to pray for her and trust her with the Lord, I'm confident that the Lord is going to greet her and that she feels very much at home. That although it's mysterious, although we don't completely understand what God is about, how the world works, how life can be so great in the Lord's presence, nonetheless, having heard stories, having known people, having been a person of faith, I'm sure the reaction is, I feel the natural. As we pray for Glenn today, we also pray for ourselves. We give thanks for the gift of the life, the way in which we touch each and every one of us. But we also pray that we will take to heart the words of the gospel, the promise of the Lord who gives faith to us, that we will truly believe that the Lord is the way and the truth and the life, and following that way, clinging to that truth and seeking that life, we too can move forward to one day, being called to His presence. We pray for Glenn. We entrust it to our God, and we pray for ourselves as a people of faith and hope, strengthened by eternal life and example, and asking the Lord to help us to persevere in the Lord.
The most important thing is for the Lord. Let us pray for Him. and that to the media, make she not share the fullness of the living, praise the Lord. That is full of mercy and compassion, may we forgive from it, any sin she committed to human reality, we praise the Lord. For my soul in water, love and love, relatives, and friends of the land, that you may find strength and consolation in the Christian faith and in the love and support of this community, we praise the Lord.
as we only present to you the sacrificial law of the Lord and salvation of your servant prayer, we receive your mercy that she who did not have her son to the loving Savior, may find in him a merciful God, who lives and reigns forever. O Lord, we give you thanks. Give us your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is true that we trust our renewed love and salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God, it is at your summons that we come to your earth by your will of your God, and at your command that we return our common sin to that earth. And when we did decide, we have indeed by the death of your Son, shall be raised up to the glory of the resurrection. And so we have to be the angels and saints, we say the King of your praise, and without end.
Thank you.
you